Usman's a fight. Conor's obviously flirted with the idea of fighting me. And if me and Conor go in the octagon, what happens? It's one of the biggest fights in history. Just by math, proving what Conor's been doing. The last couple of fights that I've had, the engagement, the pay-per-views that broke records with ESPN. So obviously, it's a formula for success, you know? Somebody will always have the belt at 170 pounds. So it doesn't really matter if it's Kamaru or not. Conor's a bigger fight. Now, if Conor doesn't do his job or Conor doesn't want to fight after his fight, then we're going to take Usman's head off. We're not in the same playing field when it comes to stand-up, and he knows it. That man can never look me in the eyes and say, I would stand with you. He's going to immediately magnetize on my crotch and do what he does, you know, avoid the fight at all costs. But we're ready for that. There's the whole world saying that Usman will this or that. And me, myself, and I saying, nah, he's not the champ. I'm the champ, and I'm going to prove it when we get in there. You know? There's a reason why he doesn't want to fight me. And he says he wants to fight a guy that's ranked under me that he already beat. He says it's a tougher fight. And how many stoppages does that individual that he's talking about have in his old record compared to mine? Usman can try to sell whatever he wants to the public. But people ain't stupid, man. You're a fucking idiot. If anybody's gonna believe this shit, you're saying you already beat that guy and he's ranked under me. Usman's coaches, they were in his corner for his last fight. Sparring partners, all that stuff, is my graduating class from American Top Team. I think a lot of you might have known the Black Zillions. They're no longer with us, but they were a part of ATT. They used to be with us. So a lot of those coaches that he has in his corner right now are the same dudes that are telling him, don't fight that guy, bro. He's gonna fuck you up, man. We know who that guy is. You know who you are. Fake the injury when the time comes, because this one's not going your way. And that's really the main reason why he doesn't like to address me, because he knows, man, this shit is for real.